Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us today for another edition of Slack, It's a Snap. Your host today, Trevor Dowd and Wendy Goldband of the Slack team. Welcome to our third episode of Slack, It's a Snap, a special show where we answer questions sent in by our QualityNet users. Today's topic is the upcoming newly designed Slack workflows. Beginning November 7th, Slack Corporate will be pushing out a new workflow experience. For this episode, we'll be reading your questions and giving you the answers you need to successfully use the newly designed Slack workflows that simplify your daily work. Let us begin with a little overview of what's happening. Then Trevor will answer questions along with some demonstrations. As of now, all old workflows that do not use webhooks will be migrated over to the new version of workflows. This is not being done all at once, so you may see for a while that some workflows are migrated and some are not. All the unmigrated workflows will appear under a tab called Legacy Workflows. Legacy workflows will be supported until September 2024. Trevor, let's begin by you first reminding our audience what workflows actually are and the advantage of using them.
Thanks, Wendy. Well, workflows are still a great tool to help you automate your daily activities in Slack. They're still no-code solutions, so anyone can do them, and they can be really simple or complex solutions to your daily repetitive tasks. They also connect to a variety of other apps and services that can help you interact with those other apps and services. As well as some of the new features, they've really created a way for you to have more robust and complete solutions to your daily Slack lives. Slack workflows allow you to automate daily and repetitive tasks. These tasks include a wide variety of use cases, some of which we'll go over now. Say you have a new user being onboarded to a channel, you can send them a welcome message. And now with the integration with Giphy, you can include in your welcome message a GIF or something fun like that to really make sure the team, you know, feels like they're welcomed to your new channel. Additionally, use cases like reminders. Say you have a meeting that is done every day. You can now include Zoom in those reminders, so that way your meetings can be accessed directly from those message reminders. Other things like suggestion box, polling, feedback is a great way to collect information from users, as well as distribute feedback in the terms of messages. You know, there really are endless use cases for these new workflows. A final one to touch on would be the addition of channel and user management. You can now add users, remove users, anything that you do repetitively. Say you have a team that you need to add to a bunch of channels, you can really cut down on your time using a workflow to add those users.
But Trevor, I have a quick question for you. If I make a workflow, can I make one that allows me to send a GIF every time I add a new member to my channel?
Yes, Wendy, you can have it set up so that way when the new user is added to the channel, they will receive a GIF using the Giphy integration, which is now natively installed in workflows.
And then could I possibly have the GIF, once it's opened, deliver forms for onboarding at the same time?
Of course, using workflows easy to use step system, you can add additional steps to add forms or additional messages to your workflow.
So Trevor, can you tell me, has the way you begin creating a workflow changed?
You'll still create them in the same way. You'll hit the top down of your Slack workspace name and scroll down to Tools and Settings. From there, you'll hit the Workflow Builder and it will open your Workflow Builder. Now you can notice the UI has changed slightly. You now have your legacy workflows under the second tab, and your new workflows will appear under this first tab. You still come up here and hit Create Workflow, and it gets you started with this new improved UI.
Trevor, can you tell me how the triggers changed?
So shortcut triggers are no longer supported in Slack. That's the big main change. Instead, they're going to use this from a link in Slack. This allows you to get a link, like so, with the example here, and it gives you real-time triggering of a workflow. So as you can see, you'll just be able to click run workflow after posting the link in any page you want to run with it. You can either do that by posting the full link or using a slash command. Once you've posted a link in your Slack channel, you can run that workflow as many times as you would like, or just the once, by pressing the button.
So, Trevor, what are the new steps added to the workflows?
Well, Wendy, steps have changed a lot. The biggest change is the addition of all these new categories, and you have a bunch of different new steps. To go over a couple of them, with channels, you can now add a bookmark, you can add people to a channel, and you can manage a channel with archiving, creation, channel topics, that sort of things. They also expanded forms. Forms now allow you to choose many more formats. There used to be just four options. Now you have many different ones. You can do a paragraph, you can select a person, you can select multiple people. The options are really limitless now with anything you might need to create a form with. All of those answer types are supported. We also expanded messages. You can now reply in a thread to a message. Whereas before you could only post a normal message, you can now thread your messages together to create a chain of messages and workflows. This can be useful if you're sending a message with a lot of dense information and you don't want it to clog up the whole channel. This will have one short message and then you can reply with more details in the threads of your message. The last two things you can do is you can manage user groups from the user steps, and you can manage your workflows with the workflow controls. This allows you to delay a workflow to cause it to, you know, if you don't want it to run right one after another, you can put a minute in between sending a form and sending a response to the form. It just allows you to have a little more granular control over the workflow. You may have noticed there are a lot of apps listed here in the steps. These apps have been natively integrated. However, only three of them, as of this date, are approved to use in QualityNet Slack workflows. They include GitHub, Giphy, and Zoom. If you're interested in using any of the other apps, you must make a request through the Workflow Builder request link next to the app. You will be notified if the app is approved or denied.
Oh! Trevor, we have a special visitor today with a question about the newly designed workflows. Barbarosaurus, go ahead.
Hello, Trevor and Wendy. So good to speak with you. I just love using workflows. They've worked wonders getting my team to hand in their daily reports on time, finally, and save me the trouble of continually reminding them. I'm excited to try some of these new features, but let me not take up your time with my chit-chat. My question is, what is the biggest change I can expect to see in the user interface?
Thanks, Barbara. It's always great to hear from you. Well, as you can see, steps are in a whole new area. That's probably the biggest change to the UI. They're over here on this right bar now, which allows you to quickly add them to your workflow and see what options you have for steps. They also allow you to search for the steps. So say you want the threads, you can just search thread and it allows you to look inside the message to get the thread reply message option. And you can do that for any different steps, and they're just right here on your right side. Does that answer your question, Barb?
Yes, Trevor. Wonderful. I love all those new answer types in the forms that we can use. I can't wait to try some out when it all begins next Tuesday.
Glad this will help, Barb. Trevor, we have time for one last question. It reads, what is the most noticeable process change when creating your workflow?
Well, Wendy, the big change that came to the process of creating a workflow is publishing a workflow. Now, when you publish a workflow, instead of naming it at the beginning, you'll name it right before you publish. So here you can put the name in. You can add a description and an image, This was all stuff that you had to do from the settings beforehand, and now it just has you do it when you publish it. It also allows you to add any collaborators and who can use this workflow. This is a new feature that allows you to granularly choose who can access your workflow. Then, once you're done, you just hit publish like normal, and you still get the confetti congratulating you on a job well done.
Thanks so much, Trevor, for all this information on the newly designed workflows that will be launched next Tuesday, November 7th. If anyone has any further questions or needs help setting up their workflow, please contact our Help Slack channel in QualityNet Slack. I highly encourage you all to join us for our Slack workflows training classes. The next training will be Tuesday, December 7th at 1 p.m. You can find other session dates, other training topics, and registration links at ESS Tools University on Confluence. And just a reminder that our Slack Confluence space is loaded with information. Be sure to check it out. So that's it for today's Slack is a Snap. Thanks for joining us.